Hello everyone, my name is Anita Sen, your science teacher from Sri Rama Bharti Public School. Today I will explain few topics from light. So let's start. What is light? Light is also a form of energy. The form of energy which gives us the sensation of seeing objects. For that we have to learn what is the reflection of light. So what is the reflection of light? The bouncing back of light from the surface of an object is called reflection of light, as you can see here in the figure. The bouncing back of light from the surface of an object is called reflection of light. Now, if you will see in the figure, you can see there is a normal, right? Then incident ray, reflected ray, and mirror. Now, what is this normal? Normal is a line perpendicular to the surface of the mirror at the point of incidence. This is the point of incidence. Normal is a line perpendicular to the surface of the mirror at the point of incidence. Now the ray of light which comes from an object and falls on the surface of the mirror, it is known as incident ray. As you can see here, OA and OB, they are incident rays. So what is incident ray? The ray of light coming from an object that falls on the surface of a mirror is called incident ray. Now the reflected ray. Now you can see the reflected ray, the ray of light that gets reflected from the mirror is called reflected ray. Then comes the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection. The angle which is formed by the incident ray with the normal means the angle which is formed in between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of incidence, which is shown with angle I. Then angle of reflection is the angle which is formed between the reflected ray and the normal, and it is shown with the angle of R. Now the laws of reflection. What are the laws of reflection? There are two main laws of reflection. The incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal to the reflecting surface lie in the same plane. That is the law, first law. And second law of reflection, the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. I will repeat. The incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal, they all are present in the same plane. And the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Now we will learn the regular and diffuse reflection. What is regular and what is diffuse reflection? First of all, we have to learn the beam of light. What is beam of light? A group of light rays coming from the same source. Again, I'm repeating. A group of light rays coming from the same source in the same direction is called beam of light. And as you can see in the figure, there are three types of beam of light: parallel beams, convergent beams, divergent beams. A group of light rays coming from the same sources in the same direction is a beam of light. And there are three types of beam of light. Parallel beam. Here you can see the beams of light are parallel to each other. Convergent beam of light. You can see the beams of light, they all actually meet at a point. They actually meet at a point. They converge. That's why they are known as convergent beam of light. Then comes the divergent beam of light. Now you can see the beam of light which is actually spread or appear to spread from a point. So means they are diverging. That's why it is known as divergent beam of light. Now regular reflection. On the basis of the reflecting surface, we can classify reflection into two types. One is regular reflection and second is diffuse reflection, as you can see in the figure also. What is regular reflection? You can see here the reflection. It is the reflection from a polished surface. It is also called the specular reflection. Reflected rays, if you will see, these are the reflected rays. These all are parallel to each other. And it can be seen in the plane mirror, unused stainless steel plate, and water. that is our regular reflection. Now, if you will see in the diffuse reflection, it always, the reflection from a rough surface, or we can say uneven surface or irregular surface, and it is called irregular reflection also. Reflected ray moves, you can see these are the reflected rays, and they can move in various directions. So the image is diffuse or irregular, and it can be seen in scratched mirrors and rippling water. So I hope you understand each and every topic clearly, and time to say goodbye.